Welcome to a special video partnership with Yamaha and Roland, two well-known companies with a shared hometown, Hamamatsu in Japan. I'm Andy from Yamaha.
And I'm Nico from Roland. We are looking at how to link Yamaha's DM3 series of digital mixing consoles with Roland's V-80HD direct streaming video switcher to enhance the control and production of live and stream events featuring multiple audio and video sources.
Yamaha's expertise in digital audio mixing goes back several decades, and DM3 series is one of the latest, highly compact yet professional consoles suitable for mixing audio at live events for audiences both in the room and online.
While Roland has one of the most successful ranges of portable video switches for live event production, V-80HD stands out with its direct streaming capabilities and advanced automation, with a perfect ratio between size and power.
With both devices using network protocols for control and communication, they have now been programmed to work together. Channels on DM3 series can be assigned on V-80HD for bidirectional control of audio levels and mutes, linking the faders and on or mute keys between both devices. Use assignable pads and macros on the V-80HD to recall scene memories on DM3 series.
This combination will be an ideal choice for a production where more microphones and other inputs are required than the V-80HD can provide. So why not also use it to control the levels of all the HDMIs and SDI sources within the V-80HD? Both devices together provide a very powerful and quick use AV event production system.
So let's see how to get them set up. First, check the firmware is going to be compatible and follow the manufacturer's instructions for updating. DM3 or DM3S, as either type is suitable, should be version 3 or newer to take advantage of the auto mixer, though versions 2 and older will still work. While V-80HD must be version 1.1 or later. Connect the network port of both devices to the same switch or same subnet and check their IP addresses are compatible. If you have the DM3 with a Dante module, make sure that Dante uses a separate switch or VLAN. In DM3 series, open the Setup menu and touch Network. Select for Mixer Control and choose the method for IP address assignment, DHCP or static. Use DHCP if a server is available to assign addresses. Otherwise, use static IP and set an address. Let's use something like 192.168.1.3. Keep the subnet mask at 255.255.255.0 and the gateway address should be compatible, so 192.168.1.1. Even if using DHCP, make a note of the IP address, as you will need to enter that into the V-80HD later. Now, open the menu of V-80HD and scroll down to Network. Press Enter and select LAN Setup. Press Enter again. In the Configure setting, the same options for DHCP and manual IP selection are available. If using manual IP addresses, make sure it's compatible. So something like 192.168.1, I'll set the number 80. And then the same subnet mask and default gateway. If using DHCP, you can scroll down to network information to check the assigned address. Once the address is assigned, scroll down the network menu to Yamaha mixer control. If you don't see it, you'll most likely need to update the V80HD firmware. Enter this menu and switch the control on. Then scroll to the mixer IP address setting and enter the IP address of the DM3, which we set just a moment ago. So 192.168.1.3. Now the audio fader assignment can be made. DM3 has 16 input channels and 6 mix buses. Any of these faders and channel on keys can be used to control any of the audio channels within V80HD. If you intend to use DM3 channels for its own audio inputs, don't assign it. Rather, use spare channels that are not needed for direct audio adjustment. For example, I can use DM3 channels 1 to 4 for 4 live microphones and then use channels 5 to 8 to control the audio of the 4 HDMI inputs in the V80HD. First, select the V80HD channel and then assign its control to a DM3 channel. Once you're done, exit from the menu and look at the audio levels, either on the built-in screen or on the V80HD remote iPad app, which can be connected via Bluetooth. Now the DM3 has control, and the DM3 reacts when an adjustment is made on the V80HD. Before proceeding, I ought to remove the input patch from the DM3 channels that I am using for control, so I don't mix unwanted background noise with the intended microphone inputs. On the home screen, touch the input gain and open the input patch. Select none for the control channels. Back in the V80HD network menu and Yamaha mixer control, see I can also control audio from the USB and Bluetooth inputs, SDI inputs, and all the output buses, stream and record. If I want to, I could use the DM3 just as a controller for the audio mixing inside V80HD. Or I could handle all audio with DM3 before passing its output to the live stream. Or I could have a hybrid approach with live microphone inputs via DM3 and audio from video sources remaining in V80HD. I shall let you find your preferred workflow, but I recommend you create a new scene memory in DM3 and name the control channels you have assigned. You can even color code them and give them a suitable icon. Store the scene and create additional scenes for different sections of the event. These scenes can then be triggered from the V80HD assignable pads. Let me show you how. Open the menu and scroll down to assignable pads. Select from bank A to H and then choose the category Yamaha mixer control, function scene recall, and then select any scene number. See, I've already assigned scene numbers 31 to 34 to pads 1 to 4. So simply press a pad to recall the scene. However, if you wish to recall a scene of DM3 in combination with a scene of V80HD for changing video sources, PNP positions, and other video settings, use a macro. Find the macro menu and select Edit. Choose one of the 100 macros and scroll to Add Function. Yamaha Mixer Control is found near the end of the list, and then any of the DM3 scenes can be selected. Macros can be triggered from the buttons above the program selectors, or why not use the iPad app with its dedicated macro page.
Now you can have much closer integration of audio and video control, even for larger events with multiple cameras, multiple microphones, and playback sources.
You can either provide more accessible hands-on controls for a single AV operator, or make it much more comfortable to separate the audio and video controls for dual operator productions.
When preparing for your next event, remember to use the Roland V-80HD with a Yamaha DM3 for a successful partnership between audio and video.
See you again soon.
Bye.